The anatomy of wood. Let's see what wood is. We start out with certain terms. This basically is going to talk about the anatomy of wood. When you see woody plants, these are plants that have an accumulation of cellulose. Wood is, by definition, the annual accumulation of cellulose and other materials that creates a durable material. If you look at this particular part, what you see is the wood. You can see there are two colors in there. You can see that one looks like normal wood. The other is a little bit tinted in it. As such, it's got other materials in it besides the cellulose. We have what we call the cambium. The cambium is the part of the plant. It's a sheet meristem that surrounds the woody stem. As it grows, it produces a cell to the inside, cell to the outside. It keeps doing this, and this eventually causes the wood to thicken, and it's the inner part that is actually used as wood. We have what we call bark. Bark is all tissues outside of the vascular cambium. It's the part of the stem or root surrounding the wood. We do have woody roots as well as woody stems. They're all covered with the bark. Then we have what we call the periderm. Periderm is a protective tissue that substitutes the epidermis of the stem and roots of plants that live more than 1 year. It contains products of cork cambium, which include cork, and felloderm. This is the outer part outside, on the outer part of the bark, that builds up over time, possibly, in some plants it is sloughed off. We also have what we call the sapwood. In this particular instance, you see the white. The white is the sapwood. These are rings of xylem that still transport xylem sap. We have what we call the heartwood. The heartwood is older, non-conducting rings of xylem at the center of the tree's trunk and roots that are often darker than the outer layers. They have an accumulation of phenolic compounds on the inside. When they do this, they have these darker layers. When we talk about wood anatomy, there are certain types of materials we find on the inside. One is a vessel. A vessel is basically a continuous water-conducting tube, and it's formed by vessel elements. So you can see vessels on the inside of this. You can see that junction parts have these little sieve plates in it that allow for passage of material from one side to the other. We have trachids. Trachids are long, non-living cells with tapered ends. They're commonly found in the xylem of all vascular plants. As you will find that these are long, tapered end materials. We also have what we call ray initials. A ray initial is an initial or a place that will give rise to material that arises between the vascular bundles. It's often cube-shaped. It's kind of like a reserve stem cell. It stays there, and all of a sudden, if something gets damaged, it can start to produce new material to fill in. The xylem itself is not living tissue. The xylem, remember, has lost its nucleus and everything else in order to be able to conduct the sap. The wood in this particular case was cut in a different manner from the one on the previous slide. When we look at porosity, we're looking at the relative size of the openings between the cells of wood. This is a way to classify wood. It's very important to understand it when you start working with wood. We have what we call ring porous wood. In the ring porous wood, if you look at the wood, it has pores at the areas where the rings are. So in the middle of the rings, it's going to have these large openings. These large openings, therefore, are going to give the wood its unique properties. This is oak. This is actual photograph of the end of a board of oak. You can see the pores in there. The pores form in a ring format. In between the pores, we have a more solid type of wood. We can have semi-porous wood. Semi-porous wood means that you've got pores scattered in different directions. We can have diffuse porous wood. Diffuse porous wood means that rather than having it along a ring, it is in a more scattered manner throughout. That's what this slide shows. Then the other one we have is ring non-porous. Non-porous wood is things like you would find in gymnosperms. That's a gymnosperm wood. Porosity becomes very important when we study the anatomy of wood. It's going to impart different abilities of the wood to do different things. All of these things go back to anatomy of woody plants. What is important as far as understanding wood? Another thing we look at is density. Density is the amount of matter per unit volume related to the wood hardness. Remember, water will have a density of 1 times 10 to the third kilograms per cubic meter. So if it's as dense as water, it will have a density of 1 ton per meter cube. Now, if we start looking at the different woods we have here, balsa, 0.13. That means that balsa is approximately 1/8 of the density of water. Bamboo goes up a little bit. Yellow pine is about half. Norway spruce, Doug fir. These are all gymnosperms. And you can see that they're going between 0.4 and 0.5. You get into the maple and the oak, which become much harder woods, much denser woods, and they're at the 0.6 or higher range. Then down at the bottom, it says we've got ebony. Ebony would have a weight, therefore, of 1.1 tons per cubic meter, which is much denser than many of the other woods. It becomes very important to look at the density of wood as well. When we're dealing with wood anatomy, we're dealing with many different things, all of which have to be taken into account in order to be able to have wood of any value.